The very first video of this new channel, I want to give a brief intro of me and my new channel. My name is Anik and we will be covering most of the subjects like theory of automata or theory for computation, databases, operating systems, design and analysis of algorithms, etc. etc. So if you are new to this channel, then please subscribe. Today we will be covering and understanding a new topic, which is line by line analysis. It will be having total 3 parts. So this is the introductory video, which has also some examples. So let's start, which is line by line analysis. Algorithm performance. What is algorithm? Algorithm is just simply the steps of operations. So we will name each operation the elementary operation. So if we take an example, in this, each operation is the elementary operation except else clause. Okay. An elementary operation is that which takes constant time. So what is constant? Constant simply means that runs in one time unit. What is running time? Running time is described as the number of elementary operations executed. So we will covering more in detail in next few slides. So operations and sequences. So as we already have studied, that takes constant time is elementary operation, and how many sequences of instructions are executed is running time. So if we take an example of assignment statements, that is these three statements, so what will be the running time? As these three run in constant time, so the running time will be 3. So what is selection statements? Selection statements like if-else statements are conditional statements, which is simply means that if condition holds, then do P1 else do P2. So for example, like this, so if this condition holds, then do this else do this. So what will be the running time? So here maximum rule will work for the desired running time of algorithms. What is maximum rule? Maximum rule states that if there are two sequences of operations and we have to select one of those sequence, then we will select that sequence which has a greater running time. So as you can see in this example, there are two sections, one is this and second one is this. So maximum of two is this. Okay, so here one is representing the if statement condition. Okay, so running time is, so here the one is representing the if condition, and maximum of these two is this. So the two will be came here. So 1 + 2 is equal to 3. So the running time will be 3. So repetition. What is repetition? Repetition is simply you have already studied in languages like for loops, do while loops, while loops, in which there is repetition. So as an example of how to find out running time of loops, this for loop is going to run n times. Okay, so P of I operation will also run in n times. Okay, any loop is distinguished by two distinctions. Okay, first one is that how many iterations will be performed, and the second one is how many steps will be performed per iteration. So these two distinctions will describe the any loop. Okay, so running time will be, because this loop will run n times, so here it will run n times t. What is t? T is an attribute of time, which is simply just time that each operation will take for execution. Okay, so what are nested loops? Nested loops are just a loop interleaved into another loop. So like this, as you can see, the inner loop is interleaved into an outer loop. So what will be the running time? As you can see in this pictorial representation, that for each n, the inner loop will going to run m times. Okay, For 0th iteration, it will run m times, then 1th iteration, the inner loop will run m times, and so same for other two also. So it means that we're going to run n times m. So we also add a t attribute here, so n times m times t as we consider it in the previous slide. So these are just formulas of series which will be helpful in the next videos or next few examples that we will be covering. This first formula is that if loop's iterations are increasing in increasing fashion like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, so on to the n, then this formula will be used. The second formula is that if inner loop's iteration or any loop's iteration is increasing in squared fashion as like this, 1, 4, 9 and so on to the n square, then this formula will be used. Okay. The other two formulas will be used in the other topics. We will cover the most of it in the next few topics. Okay. So those formula will be used in complex nested loops also. If you have noticed the inner loop here, the inner loop, it is running from 0 to ith times. Okay. And here I is the counter of outer loop. So it simply means that iterations of inner loop will be changing at execution time. If we check in this pictorial representation, this is outer loop which will run 0 to 3 times as an example, that is 4 times. So for first iteration, the inner loop will run 1 time because inner loop will be running from 0 to I and I here is 0. Okay, so for first iteration I is 0 and if I is 0, so 0 to 0 is one iteration. Okay, so for second iteration it will also run for 2 times and for third iteration it will run 3 times and for fourth iteration it will run 4 times. So here notice iterations of inner loop is running in an increasing fashion. Okay, so what will be the running time? As we have seen the formulas in previous slides, there we saw a formula that was for iterations which was running in increasing fashion. Okay, so the running time will be like this. So first n is, this n is representing the outer loop which will be running for n times, and this summation is for the inner loop which will be running in an increasing fashion, and p of j is also and this summation is representing this p of j operation, and t is the time it will takes. Okay, so I have populated the formulas and computed the result and I get the running time of this specific code. So okay, more examples in next videos. If you find it helpful, then please do subscribe. Thank you.